All right, well, I've been fascinated with Laser Sabre's easy spin motors ever since he started building them. And he's now having them 3D printed. You print them up on a 3D printer and wind the coils and add a few parts. And they're amazing little electric motors. And I don't have a 3D printer, and I'm too cheap and too lazy to have one printed. So I thought I would give a stab at building a somewhat of a replication of the device. And this is a replication built up on a board with electronics instead of a reed switch. And it's a simple rotor lid motor with four magnets and eight coils around the perimeter. And the way the easy spins work is the coils are in series around the rotor, and there are fewer magnets to the coils, and the coils are north, south, north, south, north, south, all the way around the rotor. So when the motor fires, the rotor is pushed and pulled around, and I thought that was very interesting, so I had to try to build one up. And you look at his videos, he's running it on a reed switch right here, and when the magnet goes by here, it fires all the coils, and it pushes and pulls the rotor around, and it's very, very efficient. And I'll give a link to his latest video where it's running on almost nothing, and mine doesn't. I'm using too big of a wire, and my coil chain is 144 ohms with 30 gauge wire, and this is the electronic version that I am quite proud of. It does work on that particular arrangement. It is a complementary transistor circuit with a PNP and an NPN. You notice the high values on the resistors here, a 1 meg and a 33K meg. I'm sorry, 33K. And a 1 meg on the components, but it's very simple. And then the coil chain, this whole chain here, just plugs into the circuit right there, and it runs on 1 to 3 volts. At 0.8, it stops. But that motor right there, with a 5 farad 2.7 volt cap filled up to 2.7 volts, will run over an hour and a half. And that's fun. Anybody that's worked on these little pulse motors, we can get them to run on a capacitor, a fairly small super cap, for a long time. It's just a lot of fun. And I got a big bang out of watching that thing go round and round for hours and hours. And it goes either direction. On the electronic version, you can start it up either way, and it doesn't matter. Of course, the reed switch is a little different, but it'll run on the crystal cell, which is why he built them using a reed switch, and it runs quite nicely. This is an old John Bedini type of crystal cell that I made with the solid crystalline structure for the electrolyte. I've decided these are basically a galvanic, high impedance galvanic. They don't put out much amperage, but they'll work on that with a reed switch. Now, if you put a couple of them in series and gang them up like Laser Sabre's doing, they'll run this, of course, electronically too. But reed switch is the way to go with the crystal cells. But anyway, that's something I've been doing here, is working with this easy spin. And boy, I tell you, I've had a lot of fun with this thing. It's been a real winner for me. And thanks, Laser Sabre, for all the time you've spent on these. Maybe one day I'll get one 3D printed. But I tell you what, he's using very, very, very fine wire. This is 30 gauge, and I think he's using 42 gauge. And boy, I tell you, even with 30 gauge, it was tedious to wind up all these coils and get it assembled. But came out nice. I mean, I'm quite happy with my little homemade easy spin type of motor, and I'm just running it on a needle. And he's running needle rotors with sapphire bearings, and that's something else. If you get really, really good bearing surfaces, of course these are much more efficient. And I'm just using a steel needle on a Phillips head brass screw for the top bearing surface, and then there's nothing underneath. So anyway, that's my latest little project here. That's the electronic easy spin. Thanks for watching.